We'll start with Zach's monthly update.
Do you want to talk about the minutes from last month first, or?
Sure.
Sorry to interrupt.
I'll entertain a motion to accept the minutes as emailed.
Motion.
Second.
Discussion?
Good minutes. Thank you. They're good.
Copious.
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 It was good to have Joe Martiri here last week, so the last time.
Because you know if I took them, they'd be three pages.
Three sentences. Yeah, looking good.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Director's report. No news is good news. A lot of crazy calls recently. We had two really significant car accidents. We had that rather difficult individual at the Circle K, made the national news even. And all I'm saying is it took like 12 cops to take care of him, but only two of our paramedics, and they just put him in the back of the truck and took him up to the hospital. So South County EMS saved the day again. Kind of looking forward, we've got the County EMS Committee. I reached out to them. Basically, I think it's time that we, with the changing stuff that's going on at Medicare, kind of their questioning about what their future looks like. And then Greenfield now has an ambulance, Turner Falls has an ambulance, Coleraine's at the paramedic level, Northfield's at the paramedic level. Thinking more strategically about how the county's looking to the future. So basically just get all the EMS people in a room, anybody who has a stake in it, and just say, what's your plan? What are you hoping to do, like Greenfield Fire, Turner Falls Fire? What are they hoping to look for? And just making sure that we're all kind of on the same page,
yeah.
So we're not doubling efforts and things like that. So,
can you explain what's going on at Medicare?
Well, it's just
they were like a individual private entity that did.
Yeah, the short story is they were a division of the Bay State Health Network,
I gotcha. And
then that ambulance division was sold off to a private company. They're actually a Canadian company.
Okay.
So it's a separate private agency, not affiliated with the hospital, so they don't have that same either back channel funding, or when it was Bay State Franklin's ambulance, they always had business because they were doing all the discharges and they could kind of justify if they were losing money. Now that it's private, things seem a little rocky up there, and just ear to the grindstone, it seems like they're spinning their tires on some things. Not to say that they're giving bad care or that they're going to collapse or anything, but just, you know, we're going more and more mutual aid. I talked to Chief Strand from Greenfield Fire recently because they have a committee in Greenfield, the Public Safety Committee, and Medicare says, oh, we only needed mutual aid six times, you know, this past month. And Strand's looking at his run numbers and he says, my dispatch center says, you know, we had mutual aid 12 times. So there's definitely some things going on where the dispatch centers aren't communicating back and forth. So I think, well, knowing that Strand's looking out for his community and trying to figure out how he's going to take care of his people with Medicare providing the paramedic service, and us just obviously not being able to subsidize Greenfield or Medicare, just trying to figure out that we're all on the same page and moving forward in the correct way.
Is Greenfield just basic?
They are just basic, and it's Greenfield Fire Department. They recently added an ambulance just in the past couple of years, so they're not paramedic level. And I know because it constituted a change in working conditions, now working and transporting ambulance, they had to renegotiate with the union and come to an agreement there. So I don't know what their situation is moving forward, whether they're looking to add like EMS related duties further, either paramedic or more ambulances, or whether they're going to stay where they are. But which is why we all just need to get in a room and figure out what's going on. So hopefully we'll have that meeting soon. Cold and flu season ravaged us. I mean, we've got with nine full-time staff, everybody needs to be healthy in order to cover all of our shifts. So we had multiple call-outs this past month. A lot of the per diem stepped up, and we're able to you know, stay staff. We didn't drop down any levels or anything like that. It did result in some overtime, but that's the nature of the beast. And we, I hesitate to say we encourage sick time, but we make it clear that we don't want sick paramedics caring for people with suppressed immune systems who the flu could be deadly. So so we always make sure we take care of our own staff first. That said, we are two of our EMT basics who upgraded to paramedic last year. They're reaching the final stage to finally work autonomously. This process takes, as you can see, a year just to be fully cleared to work with just another EMT. Right now they're in a stage where they have to work with another paramedic still. So with those two people completing their upgrade process, that'll alleviate some of the burden. And we have some recent highly recommended per diem paramedics who I've spoken to and explained the system and interviewed, and they're interested in coming aboard. And so looking forward, just kind of augmenting that normal attrition with our other staff. Outreach, weather's getting nicer, so more and more events are happening. Just in the past 30, 40 days, we've had a number of events. And, you know, I'd like to, I say it in my report, if anybody in the community, you know, they have an organization, they're planning an event, anything like that, if they think that South County EMS or an ambulance or emergency medical providers could bring something to their event, either stand by because it's a 5K, or it's a show and tell because it's a school science fair, whatever it is, feel free to reach out. That's one of the things that we're here to do. So just kind of as a cap, just in the past month, what we've done, all the department heads met in Deerfield. We got brand new AEDs on a grant, and one of them is in the Deerfield Town Hall. And it kind of made everybody realize, what was the last time we had CPR stuff?
Love that.
Yeah, our staff trained the last round of CPR and AED, so we're looking to do that again, make sure everybody's updated, there's new equipment now. Bringing that service to Deerfield with that extra training before an emergency. In Sunderland, we just had the, I want to make sure I get this correct, Sunderland Elementary School Science Festival, which was organized by the Frontier Regional Coordinated Family and Community Engagement Program. Which is this event that they have annually at the Sunderland Elementary School for the kids. They have like science experiments, and you can like make the foam, and you can do the archaeology stuff. And one of the things is the fire department comes over, and also the ambulance. And it's a huge hit. I mean, one, it's an emergency vehicle, so kids love that. But it also gives them an opportunity to interact with our staff and ask questions about what happens in an emergency with the EMTs and paramedics before the situation is hectic or scary. So they meet our staff, they see the equipment in a totally familiar environment at the elementary school, in a environment of learning, and that way, if anything ever did happen, God forbid, it wouldn't necessarily be a totally new, new thing. So that's always a huge hit. Two of our local EMTs were the ones who staffed that. So, and they're actually both from Sunderland. So our Sunderland EMTs took our third ambulance over there, which meant that we had both ambulances still available for emergency calls.
That's awesome.
So yeah, it was really, really great. And the Deerfield, what is it, Fun Fair? Is that what it's called?
Fun Fair.
So a similar event is gonna be happening in Deerfield in May.
Yep, May 13th.
May, when is it?
13th.
May 13th, okay.
Yep.
So we'll be there as well.
Great.
So that was Sunderland. And then Whately, we've got the annual Whately Mother's Day Half Marathon, which is on Mother's Day, May 14th, and South County EMS will be there. And in that instance, it will be lending support in a public safety emergency medical situation. So dehydrated people or even just bystanders that might have an emergency will be there and will be interacting with the public. So if people want to come up, they can talk to us. There's also the All States Asphalt one that we will also be at, which didn't make it into this report.
Sure.
What is it called? Pound the Pavement.
Pound the Pavement,
5K/10K, wow. Starting and stopping at the Sunderland Elementary School. So we'll be there. And then big picture, kind of as far as outreach goes, in October there's going to be the Hard Knocks exercise, which is a federal level disaster exercise. And this is something that the feds do. They pick a region and then they incorporate local and state resources. It's going to be in Franklin County in October, and us, I want to make sure I get this right, South County EMS, Conway Fire and EMS, and maybe Colerain or Northfield. We've all stated that we want to participate in this, and it's twofold. One is it gives our staff the experience of doing that, kind of getting your feet wet in a large exercise before a real event, just like having the kids over at the elementary school. And then also as a, you know, just checking in and seeing what is the state of our resources in Franklin County and what do we need to improve on moving forward. So we'll be participating in that. So that's very exciting. And that's just some of the outreach stuff that we're doing just in the past month. So, Carolyn.
I'm sorry.
Hey.
You missed all my outreach stuff.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry. I was trying to clean up my vegetable garden, and I didn't realize it was so late.
All right.
Let's see. What else? Equipment?
So Zach.
Yeah.
Conway's having a parade June 17th or 16th, 17th or 250. Was South County going to make an appearance?
Yes, we will be there. They've reached out to us. They're going to be staffing. It's the Conway 250th celebration. So not only is it their 250th, but they're also expecting a large turnout just because of the tornado and supporting the community. So we've already coordinated with them. We're going to be doing a few things, primarily just giving our services so the local EMTs and first responders can participate in the events.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you.
So South County will be there. It's going to be us and I believe Hilltown will be sharing those duties. We'll be taking different shifts. So we'll be there to respond to emergencies so they can participate in the activities.
Yeah, what dates did you say it was,
Seth? The Conway thing.
It's like June 17th.
Yeah.
17th, 16th, 17th, 18th.
16th, 17th, 18th. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Conway Festival of the Hills.
Okay.
250th.
And I just want to make sure it's on your calendar for October 19th.
The Hard Knocks exercise.
Yep.
Yeah. Just spoke
okay.
about that.
Yep.
Okay.
And in my director's report, I listed even specific things, Deerfield, Sunderland, and Waverly, just as an example in the past 30 days of some outreach we've been doing.
I'm having John Taylor do ICS 101 and, 100 and NIM 700 in the Deerfield Town Hall on the 12th and 13th in the evening. And so I'm hoping that anybody in our communities that want to participate, it will be for free. We'll pay for it. And that way we can get people certified.
Is that next month?
June.
12th and 13th.
12th and 13th. It's a Monday and a Tuesday night.
Yep.
And John Taylor is, of course, really talented and makes it interesting. But we haven't had our EDS drills for 2 years now. And so what I wanted to do was to reach out to all our volunteers, and including, you know, all our medical people and stuff like that, and try to have them get certified, and then try to sign people up somehow for the Hard Knocks. We've been having the phone. I have not actually gone to a meeting. I have phoned in because the meetings are in Beverly at like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so it's so gross to come home. So I haven't actually done the painful drive out there to FEMA headquarters, but I have been participating on the phone, and they do want us to do the, you know, mass casualty transports, and they are trying to get more community participation. So we're working on it, and I'm meeting with Dennis Anir next week sometime, and we're going to sort out how we can get more locals involved and stuff like that. So I'll have more updates on that, but I appreciate the fact that you're willing to participate in that, Zach.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Looking forward to it.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it. Moving on, this truck, this new truck, this replacement truck, final inspection is Monday.
Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, exciting.
I know. It'll
where,
be.
Where is that?
New Jersey is the builder. So they're going down final inspection, just making sure everything is in the right spot. And
will it be lettered there, or does it come back here to get lettered?
No, it should be lettered
there.
It's
all done there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice. Everything's installed there. All of our extra equipment, that we were transferring out of our old ambulance has already been removed from that and brought down there.
Oh, so do you have a bunch of old bandages and gauze that you have available so Gary can cry into that when they decommission the... Gary, your home is going to be retired.
That's
your home for many years.
That's been a great truck. That truck actually takes over frontline duty when...
Maybe I should get rid of your first one. And
I know, right? I just asked for an unofficial quote on what it would cost to remount the box on the international truck, just to have an idea about that type of thing. So.
We should really look at how much our repairs and our downtime is costing us, and then make that evaluation pretty soon.
Did they get that figured out yet? Or I remember you were having trouble, and they were having trouble finding what that. I'm trying to remember what it was. It was a coolant leak, right? And the hose kept blowing off, and then.
Oh yeah, no, that's fixed, but the airbag broke.
Oh, now the airbag.
Yeah, mind you, it has over 100,000 miles, and they're emergency response miles.
Right.
You know, so obviously we're going to encounter a lot of things on this truck that it's driven hard, and we wake it from a sleep and drive it to an emergency. So there's a lot of wear and tear on these vehicles. But I mean, you're absolutely right. We need to do a breakdown, figure out, you know, what's this truck costing us for maintenance, you know, and is it?
Well, it's just, but what bothers me is the downtime.
Yeah.
The constant.
Yeah.
Having to rotate. I mean, now that we're getting a newer truck, it's, you know, I'm not feeling as nervous, but at some point you just say, this is not worth it. And this is, a lemon kind of situation.
Yeah. I hesitate to call it a lemon. I think it's certainly down more often than the other trucks. It's also used more often than the other trucks. You know, we cycle things through. So, part of, what was it? The police department has 5 cruisers and they use 2 at a time because they know that just the nature of the beast is that these things,
That's why we
That's why we have an extra.
We rotate it. I know.
Let's see. Facility, nothing to report. Dick Kalicheski's just spoke with DA about time frame-ish stuff, so he was just going to coordinate with that, but...
As far as I know, it's moving on, but we have to have a total hands off.
Right, which is why there's nothing to report. It's not that nothing's happening; it's just that
nothing to report.
I don't know by design. So
great.
great.
I want to make that clear that we just don't know.
We just don't know.
Yeah.
And then lastly, budget administration, warrant articles, stuff like that. I've sat down with Brenda. The town accountant in Deerfield numerous times. I've also met with the financial committee, capital improvement plans committee multiple times to try to figure out enterprise fund stuff. And there's some nuanced stuff. Just basically, we wanted to set up an ambulance replacement fund where we channel that money in and it grows every year. DOR says can't do that. So that money that we were going to put in a fund is just going to have to remain in retained earnings. It operates the same way. It just means that we have to account for...
Why can't we put that in a Deerfield stabilization fund, a capital stabilization fund? You're able to do that.
So
we're actually creating a capitalization fund and this town meeting, and we're actually going to fund it, hopefully, to $200,000.
But I thought you could,
so
I thought you could earmark. I thought you could specifically earmark.
You can't really say you're saving it. Because it's the same thing when we used to save money for fire.
Yeah, but it's different now, Bobby. You actually have a capital stabilization. That's something within the last 3 or 4 years that you have.
So we can. DOR said that is absolutely acceptable. We can do a capital stabilization fund for South County EMS. However, it is a town of Deerfield stabilization fund, and thus Deerfield has ultimate 100% control over it. So if we decide to do that, the recommendation is that the IMA should be changed, amended, or whatever to reflect...
Clarify
the Board of Oversight's role in deciding how that money is used.
And what I would suggest is that the Deerfield Finance Committee continues to have problems with retained earnings, because that is actually who has the biggest problem. Then we need to all get together and have that discussion. Mm-hmm. If you make us capital stabilization in the town of Deerfield, and Deerfield has control over it, there has to be some understanding. about how the money comes out.
I was just gonna say, that has to be.
And I understand it has come by the vote, by the town and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Or we will have to have retained Ernie. And Deerfield Finance, and again, that's their prerogative, they struggle with that concept.
I will say in their defense, they seem more okay with it this year than they did last year. I think they're getting used to the idea at least.
Yeah, but they just, and we just have to call it, they have to understand that we just call it, it's a different name, but why it's there. And I think somehow we have to have that agreement somehow.
I see this as kind of a step thing. I think we've got kind of word from DOR now about the proper way to be doing this, and that's, you know, step one, right?
Yep.
So what are our options available to us now that we know that exactly? Moving forward, how do we within what they give us make sure that we're doing what makes the most sense for us and protecting ourselves?
When we set this up and the Board of Oversight and all that kind of stuff, we just didn't anticipate all the hassles of it, the fiscal agent hassles. And this is one of the fiscal agent hassles. And I think we just have to keep working on it.
I don't really care as long as that we work through it. And again, retained earnings is a concern with, and again, I haven't been to a lot of finance committee meetings in Whiteley, but I have in Sunderland. And Sunderland retained earnings, that doesn't, it's not a blip on the radar screen.
Right.
But in Deerfield, it's always a big, or has been, a big blip.
Yeah.
So how do you get them, how is it understood that the retained earnings is kind of like our capital stabilization, because that's the only, our only way to hold it? And
exactly.
And maybe it's education.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a lot of it.
Yeah, part of it is. And just in explaining what that number is every year. Because, we have always contributed to the ambulance when we were single-A Deerfield. And so the idea of putting money aside so that when you need to replace the ambulance, you have the money there in cash is certainly not an alien concept to the committee. It's just we have to designate it somehow and keep an idea of what is in the amount every year, so that people don't look at that and say, oh my God.
You're building up so much and then all of a sudden it drops and then all of a sudden it builds up.
I mean, we got to fix it.
It's education.
You're right. And we just make sure that we line item it or something internally.
So that's just my concern.
Yeah.
We'll have to do some.
What else you got, Zach?
I think that's it for me.
I just want to say that we were worried in March about overtime, and that seems totally under control. The last three pay periods, it was, this past pay period was $636, which is absolutely wonderful.
A lot of sick time.
Well, and I did warn them that we just had the flu come through our, and we had to utilize overtime for some of that backfill. But
I want to thank you for that. I know it's a lot of work. And
it's just that we were averaging almost $4,000, and now the last three pay periods didn't even reach our average. So this is fantastic. So we're not going to have a shortfall if we can keep this up.
Right.
I mean, besides the flu issue. And I know that there were some personnel issues and stuff. But in general, this seems to be, we'll be able to finish the year off without any shortfall, which is huge.
Yeah, and they're staffed up now. And
we're
in good shape.
Yeah, and it seems like everything's okay. So it's good.
Okay.
And I know Zach has been working with Wendy on some stuff, and it has really, and I want, you can't talk about personnel issues, but Zach has been really good and handles stuff really well, and I think people need to know that.
Yeah.
And I think there's a positive, beneficial solution to that is going to be occurring very soon, and everybody's going to, returning to the way things are, so that's... Right, I don't want to talk about it here, but I think it's working out pretty perfectly.
You have handled it really well, and I just think it should be part of the oversight board's minutes that there was good job.
Yeah, second that.
Anybody have any questions for Zach? Stuff we haven't covered?
No, Zach, you'll be at the town meeting on Monday, right?
I am a voting member of the town. I will be there whether or not.
Well, you can come and vote for
small government. Small government at work.
I'm rounding up my mosquito votes. No, I just wanted to make sure that you were there for questions and stuff.
Oh, of course.
If there was any questions.
Of course. And I attended that the public information night last night to see what questions we might get, and nobody in the audience seemed to have anything about South County, and our regular faces, I didn't bring anything up. I think that, you know, we've been answering their questions all along.
Yeah, you've done a good job of that.
Yeah.
So are you gonna... any questions on why the budget went down so much?
are you going to bring the ambulance to the town meeting?
Yeah, we can absolutely park it up front. I know the crews like to come by, and at least...
Yeah. Well, I would say, I mean, Friday, next Friday, Sunday, the 28th. I don't know when Whiteley, here, you know, here.
Tuesday.
So
it's like Monday, Tuesday.
I mean even if you have the duty crew just take it over and you know, just the half hour before, the half hour after, you know, just so people can see.
Not because they're going to need it either.
Right.
Oh, I don't know. I might have a heart attack. Hey, I just want you to know, it's 18 minutes from my house down to here. It's like the farthest you can go.
Yeah.
But I think, Zach, if possibly, it'd be a nice show if you have the whoever's on duty. That
yeah, of course.
Take them to the... And again, it's... I mean... So the one thing is that it's not a huge thing, is just communication to per diems. I think that's a big thing.
Mm-hmm.
And if you could just make, you know, whatever efforts we can make to keep the per diems involved, and the old, you know, the old EMTs from the towns, I'd just like to keep them in our thoughts.
And that's why I was hoping that you would reach out to them when we get more information on what our role is going to be in the Hard Knocks exercise, because I would really like them to participate.
Yeah, well, of course.
It would be a huge opportunity.
That's who would show up. If we have a disaster, you know those guys would show up.
Those are the people that I count on. And so, but it's just an opportunity, and I'm, you know, if people put it on their calendars, then we can figure out something. And as soon as I know more information on how... the scenario. My understanding is Dennis is going to try to make Thursday. The hurricane is supposed to hit on Tuesday, and the exercise is from
this is only
Thursday
a drill. This is only a drill.
Saturday.
Hurricane.
What's the hurricane name?
Oh, I don't know. That.
Carolyn.
Hurricane Carolyn.
Hurricane Carolyn.
This
is only a drill.
I know. But anyway, so we're going to try to do some
hurricane
scenarios.
The hurricane's right on Tuesday.
We have. It will be sort of like the Irene kind of scenario, you know, for us. But then when the Harriman Dam is let go for the FEMA people, I mean, we're completely wiped out. So
this is
only
a drill. The Harriman Reservoir is
only a drill.
So, you know, that's why I don't know how we're going to participate with the feds in the, you know, when that let's go, but we will still be able to do quite a bit with the hurricane, and that's really what I want to go through all the lists of stuff. If you can dig out your notes of our after action meetings on the Irene, Zach, and different things, anything that's not addressed, we want to make sure we are addressing, and it's part of the scenario. So we'll be focusing in on that. I'll let everyone know. But the per diems, that was really who I wanted to outreach to and have participate, and any of our CERT members and different, all our volunteer lists from the EDS. So we just need to publicize it. And if you could ask everybody, you know, just mention it once in a while, put it on the calendar. So, because I'm just so worried that we had over 100 volunteers in our communities, and I, you know, not having the EDS every year really makes me nervous that, you know, people's contact information and
cell phones,
just, all that kind of stuff is really hard to keep up.
Pizza parties.
Yes.
That's a good idea.
Pizza party.
Well, we're going to do something, so.
Definitely.
Okay.
Anything else to come before board? Or I'll entertain a motion.
Motion to adjourn.
All in favor?
Aye.